Documents submitted before the Parliament's Presidential Affairs Committee of Parliament today indicate that the state house seeks 57.14 billion shillings to buy security, household items and vehicles for the presidency, although only 21.722 billion shillings has been allocated in the 2024-2025 national budget against the desired budget of 57.14 billion, thus leaving the presidency with a funding gap of 35.418 billion shillings.
There's a funding gap of 6.549 billion to procure vehicles for the principals. The 40% cut on development in the financial year 2022-2023 greatly affected this item, and there is need to reconsider the deduction and also consider the fact that the item is grossly and underfunded given the aging fleet of vehicles for the principals. Number five, there is a funding gap of 14.41 billion to continue with the process of refurbishing State House and Entebbe. Donations, the 30 billion, there was a deduction on this item in the financial year of 2022-2023, which needs to be reinstated.
The State House controller also revealed that State House is also seeking 6.549 billion shillings to procure vehicles for the President and the Vice President, as well as another 8 billion shillings for travel abroad. She urged that although there was a freeze on procurement of government vehicles by the Cabinet, the President's travels are crucial. Documents reveal that in this financial year, 10 new vehicles have been procured to replace the aging fleet. On top of that, funds are also needed to carry out the mandatory maintenance of the presidential jet and helicopter. State House also seeks reinstatement of the 30 billion budget for presidential donations. Barechi noted that this item suffered a budget cut which needs to be reversed due to the increased pending presidential pledges.
Staff allocations, there is a funding gap of 16.986 billion. And the explanation goes that in the execution of its mandate of facilitating the presidency, State House operations are largely field-based.
Today, the president visited one family in 2012. That is a cultural woman called Madame Susanna. The president visited there and promised the family just very small things. A tractor, is it wants to also support.
State House is also seeking 4.2 billion shillings for increased wage requirements, with Barechi revealing that these funds are required to cover the cost for the ongoing requirements by the presidency to fill key positions.
I had explained that the 4.2 is the current deficit on the wage, but when we project the recruitments to come, there is another gap of 4 billion that we project in that financial year, making it 8.4.
To SFC.
Yes.
Do they also give allowances to these FSCs taking care of people like Pastor Bujingo and other people, you know?
No.
And how are they being paid, those kind of
people? Members, we get this deployed, for example, to guard you, Honorable Dennis. You will be the one to pay the allowances.
However, members of Parliament on the Presidential Affairs Committee queried the performance of State House monitoring units, especially those dealing with corruption, urging that they have fallen short of their mandate.
This is a big issue. As we appropriate money, there must be accountability for money. Why is corruption increasing?
About the issues of security or anti-corruption, issues of corruption in this country, we have been allocating money to State House, and we expect them to do something about the issues that are being raised and the reasons why this money is being appropriated to them.
That have been investigated by the anti-corruption unit under State House. I know about several cases my office has been involved in.
Report by Fred Kajubi.